In today's video, we're going to have a look at four different features of English pronunciation which are present in all accents of English. I'll be giving examples of how these features, these characteristics, appear in several pop songs to help you understand what I mean so that you can ultimately improve your own pronunciation. This is why I call the video Improve Your Pronunciation Through Songs. As you will see, I'm going to be giving you lots of links and QR codes throughout the video. For immediate access, my advice is for you to scan the code with another device, with a mobile phone or with a tablet, as you watch the video at the same time. You can also find the links in the description below the video. However, the best option perhaps is to visit the link you can see here. This is the link to my blog post where you can find everything. So you can either visit the link here or scan this QR code. And as I'm saying, you can find everything there. All the links to the songs, the links to the resources I'll be mentioning at the end, and to the exercises I'll be suggesting. Before I tell you about the tips, there's something you need to know if you really want to improve your pronunciation. Whenever you speak a different language, you need to become an actor or an actress, and you need to somehow put on your English speaking hat. And what do I mean by that? When you speak a different language, your voice needs to sound different, because different languages have different sounds, different intonations, different rhythms. So if you've noticed that your voice sounds different in English, it means you're doing fine. That's totally fine. However, sometimes students may be a bit ashamed to use a different voice or to pronounce properly in front of their classmates because they think people are going to laugh at them or they think they're going to sound too different from their own speaking voice. So please, when speaking a different language, don't be afraid to be playing a part. So put on your English speaking hat and sound different. That's totally fine. In fact, I always recommend somehow selecting role models to have good examples of pronunciation in your mind and somehow try to imitate them. You will probably have some idols of your own, some actors, actresses, singers, celebrities you like. So try and imitate, if they are native speakers, of course, try and imitate the way they speak. If you would like to have some more ideas of these good examples of pronunciation, you have some suggestions here. These are just some speaking voices I like. And you have in here some films and TV shows, which I feel are useful if you want to improve your English. As I said, you can find all these links in my blog post in the link I gave you at the beginning, so there's no need to click everything. So, these are the four tips or the four features, characteristics I'm going to be describing in this video. The first one has to do with aspiration in English, which is a bit different from Spanish. And aspiration is something you can find in words such as pee, cool, or when you say the word happy. I'll be describing that in a minute. The second tip has to do with what we call in English weak forms. Some words, such as of, to, or a, have strong forms and weak forms, depending on the context where you pronounce them. But I would say that 85 or 90% of the times, you pronounce them in a very weak form, such as when you say cup of tea, cup of tea, want to dance, or a bag. The third tip has to do with this initial S at the beginning of words, followed by a consonant rather than a vowel. This tends to be very difficult for Spanish speakers because we don't have this in Spanish. So some people might find it a bit difficult to say expressions such as in Spain or to stay. The last characteristic is not compulsory. It doesn't happen all the time, but it is very, very frequent. And if you can notice it and you can use it, you're going to sound perhaps more native-like. It's something, the name is irrelevant, it's something called jod coalescence, it doesn't really matter. This is what happens when you have these two words, these two sounds together, like when you say want you, I want you to stay, I want you to go, or when you say would you, good you. I'll be explaining what this is and the effect it has a bit later. So, let's start with tip number one, which has to do with aspiration. If you're a native speaker of Spanish, you might find this sound a bit difficult. Not difficult, but it doesn't come naturally. Because in Spanish we have words such as jamón or Gijón, which contain this rather strong h sound. And just we tend to transfer this sound we have here, we tend to think that this is going to be similar, and it isn't exactly, because this sound in English is much more relaxed. So you'd say something like and you would use it in words such as happy, here, him, her, hide, hate, heaven. It is not so hard on your throat. In Spanish, when I have sore throat problems, I find it, you know, it stresses me a bit to say jamón Gijón. It's very hard on your throat. Whereas in English, hide, hate, heaven, this is very soft. I would like to illustrate this sound with two songs. The first one is the Beatles' Help. And you can play it here if you scan the QR code, or you can find the link below in the description of the video. I hope you will notice that when they sing this, they say help, 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 as I was saying, in a very relaxed way. I never needed anybody's help in any way. You can also scan the code here and listen to Pharrell Williams's Happy, where he mentions or he sings the word happy and happiness many times. And again, I hope you will notice that his pronunciation of this sound is more relaxed than in Spanish. So trying to imitate the Beatles and Pharrell Williams, when you find yourself pronouncing these sounds, try to make them in a more relaxed way than you would probably do it in Spanish. Let's have a look now at these sounds in English. They are not very complicated. They are rather similar to Spanish. However, in some contexts, they might have a bit of an aspiration. Typically, when you have just one syllable words, such as p, t, or cool, typically, these sounds are going to have a bit of an aspiration. Let me give you an example. When you say the word pan in Spanish, if you say voy a comprar pan, it doesn't sound the same as when you use this word in English. You know, if you want to fry food, if you want to fry potatoes, you need a frying pan, pan, pan. It's not a pan, but a pan. Okay, so this is exactly the same as when you talk about a P. Okay, you have this aspiration when you have these sounds at the beginning of stressed syllables. It doesn't have to be just one syllable words, but it has to be the beginning of stressed syllables. And as I say, it happens with these three sounds, such as P, T, or cool. Can you notice the difference? In Spanish we say tijera, but in English we say t. If you wanted to imitate an American or a British speaker speaking Spanish, many times you would say pan, pásame el pan, or donde está la tijera? And we tend to imitate them when they try to speak Spanish with these aspirations, because this is what you actually find in English. Okay? So it's a P, T, co. When you have these sounds at the beginning of stressed syllables. If you want to notice how you pronounce these sounds in isolation or in very simple words, you can watch this very short video, this very, very short BBC video called Alpha Blocks, which is intended for very young children learning to read and write. But you have words such as this one, top, and you can hear actually how they pronounce in isolation these t, p, k sounds. It's very short. These are some more examples that you can practice if you want to. You can find a pie, a pen, tea, cat, true, cry, price, play, twin, a close. And again, I'm going to give you some examples of songs where you can see these aspiration being present. For example, Sia's very famous song, Chandelier, starts saying this: party, party girls, don't get hurt, can't feel anything, when will I learn? I push it down, I push it down. You can listen to Sia singing it here. Another song by Sia here, where you can find that she says, I am titanium. Again, you can scan the code here or find the link below. And one more song by the Beatles called Penny Lane, where you can find aspirations, like when Paul McCartney sings Penny Lane. This pocket is a portrait of a queen. He likes to keep his fire engine clean. It's a clean machine. And also the sound. He likes to keep his fire engine clean. Try and pay attention to the way Paul sings these sounds here. You can try and pronounce these sentences, these example sentences, to practice this aspiration I was talking about. Try and concentrate on the way you pronounce cook, putting. The cook is putting a pie on the kitchen table. Tim couldn't turn on his computer on Tuesday. Or tell Kate the price of a train and plane tickets. My second tip has to do with what we call the weak forms of grammatical words. Okay, in English there are some words such as nouns, verbs, adjectives and adverbs which give you information. They have a content and you need to understand them clearly. However, there are some others such as prepositions, some pronouns, some auxiliary verbs, which are not that important. And in English, there is something essential for pronunciation and intonation, which is rhythm. So in English, you need to hear a music somehow when you're speaking. Titown, 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 something like that. Okay, so for example, in a sentence like this, okay, there are some words which are relevant, like want, break, free. And the others, when you say them, you need to understand, I want to break free. I want to break free. And probably this word here in the middle is not that important. Something similar happens when you say, he's calling from Paris. He's calling from Paris. What you need to understand really is calling and Paris. And the words in the middle, are not that important. Something similar would happen when you say, I've bought a pair of jeans. I've bought a pair of jeans. Can you notice that you can actually only hear three words? bought a pair of jeans, I've bought a pair of jeans, and all the other words are somehow weaker, not that strong. More examples when you say, I'd like a cup of tea, please. I'd like a cup of tea, please. Or when you say, the show must go on. The show must go on. This is what you pronounce properly and really. Show, go on. The show must go on. So this is why we talk about these weak forms. There are lots of examples of these weak forms. Some auxiliary verbs, as I said, prepositions, linking words. I'm just going to concentrate here on these words. When you say for as a strong form sometimes, but very probably you're going to say for you. When you say of, or you simply say of, you say to, or maybe just to. Sometimes the auxiliary verb have, or simply of. The article, sometimes just the. The indefinite article a, or when you say from. I'll give you some examples again. Remember, in a sentence like this, this is not that important. So you wouldn't say, I want to break free. In connected speech, unless you wanted to emphasize it, you would probably say, I want to break free. I want to break free. And this is why many times, because this is so weak, you might find that the pronunciation is actually something like wanna, I wanna break free, I wanna break free. Because you say, I want to break free, I wanna break free. As I say, in connected speech, when you're connecting the words, if you pronounced this alone, then no, you would say to. A similar example here, you would probably say, if you're reading all of this connected, you would probably say, he's calling from Paris. Or you would say, I've bought a pair of jeans. Not really stressing this or this, because this is not important. I've bought a pair of jeans. Very relaxed and very weak. Typically, you'd say, I'd like a cup of tea, please. I'd like a cup of tea. Many times, you can simply say, I'd like a cup of tea, please. A cup of tea. Informally, you might find this. I'd like a cup of tea, please. Or when you say, the show, you don't actually say the, say the show must go on, the show must go on. If you don't believe me, and you shouldn't, please listen to Sia's song Tip Thrills and listen to this particular bit, which you can hear here, when she says, baby, I don't need dollar bills to have fun tonight. As I said, in a very relaxed and weak way, to have fun tonight. For example, you can listen to Ed Sheeran's Shape of You. And I hope you can notice that he's not exactly saying off. He's saying, I'm in love with the shape of you. Or for example, the verb have, when it is not giving information, when it doesn't mean have got or possess, but it is just an auxiliary verb, especially in perfect modal verbs. When you say something like Adele says in her song, hello, and again, notice how she pronounces this in a very relaxed way, hello. So she says, I must have called. She doesn't actually say must have called, like three words. No, it's just all together. It's just one hit. I must have called 1,000 times. You can find exactly the same in Adele's song, again, Rolling in the Deep, with another perfect modal verb when she says, we could have had it all. You can listen to it here. You can try and pronounce these sentences here. saying something like, it's for me, or it takes a lot of time, or would you like a cup of coffee, or are you going to the park, to the park, or this is the best band ever. Let's move on now to the third tip, which is the trouble Spanish speakers especially might have when you have an initial S, a S sound at the beginning of a word, typically followed by a consonant. If there is a vowel after it, there is no problem there. In Spanish, we don't tend to have an S sound at the beginning and then a consonant. So we find it a bit strange to pronounce words in isolation, such as spring, street, square, spell, stand, start, stranger, stress, sleep, school, or stop. Unfortunately, many times, because we don't have that sound, we tend to say something like, is spring. No. Try to avoid using any or creating any vowels before that sound. No. It's spring, street, square. So try and practice that. The problem is even worse with the name of our own country, because it contains that sound in English. Okay? So you should say Spain. Let me give you a tip to pronounce this properly, especially if those words come after another word. I tend to say that you can think of this in two ways. You can imagine that you're splitting the word in a different way. Instead of saying in Spain, imagine you put this sound at the end of a previous word and then you start a new word. So you would say in Spain. That way there is no room for this vowel, which doesn't exist, to appear here. So you could say I live in Spain. Or you could say, imagine, you know, in German you have very long words. So imagine, instead of English, this is German, and you have a very long word. And say it all together and say, I live in Spain. I live in Spain. You could say, for example, that you feel more confident talking or speaking in Spanish or in Spanish. Or, very typical, when somebody asks you where are you from, you can say I'm from Spain. Or you could say I'm from Spain. I'm just trying to avoid, these are just probably silly examples, but I'm just trying to prevent you from using this vowel, which does not exist. So you can try and practice with these examples here. You could say that you are from Spain, or that you live in Spain, or that you want to speak in Spanish, or it happened in spring, in the street, that you want to stay, that something is going to start, that you're going to school, that she can't spell, or I can't stand, or I don't like being with strangers. You can find a very nice example of this particular pronunciation of this sound here in Ariana Grande and Justin Bieber's song Stuck With You. And the lyrics contain lots of examples of these kinds of words. So stick around, to stick around, one strike, still laying, I'm staying, I'm stuck with you, stuck with you, stuck with you. So if you want to practice, this is a very good song actually that you can listen to here. And the video contains the lyrics as well. And a really nice song to notice this as well is Queen's The Show Must Go On. When Freddie sings, "Inside my heart is breaking, my makeup may be flaking, but my smile still stays on." Connecting all of these words, which is just excellent. My smile still stays on. Finally, you can find another example with Elton John's song, "I'm Still Standing." And you have these two examples here. Don't you know, I'm still standing, I'm still standing here. The last feature, the last characteristic I'm going to tell you about is something called coalescence. The name doesn't really matter, it's irrelevant. This is what happens most of the times for most speakers when they connect words such as want you. They don't say want you, so separate. They tend to say want you, or when they say good you. No, they tend to say good you, something like that. As I say, this is not obligatory, this is not compulsory, but it happens very frequently. When you have the last sound of a word is a t sound, and then the following one is the sound you have at the beginning of the word you, or year, for example. But I'm going to give you all examples with the word you. So what happens is that the sound you get, instead of saying, I'll get you, sometimes, or many times, you hear ch, ch, like the Spanish ch sound. Okay, so instead of saying, I'll get you, you will probably hear, I'll get you. I'll get you a cup of coffee. I'll get you this. I'll get you a car. Okay? This is what you find when you say, I want you to stay. I want you to stay. Or I hate you. I hate you. This sound here, I hate you. When you ask this question tag, didn't you? Didn't you? Or don't you know? Don't you agree? Don't you think? Okay, so this is, as I say, this is the same sound as we say in Spanish when we say cha-cha-cha, for example. Ch-ch. That's that sound. Another possibility is when the last sound in a word is a d sound, and then you have this sound here, like, as I said, like when you say you or year. What you get is not exactly ch, but rather j, j, j. The same sound you make when you say John or George. Okay? So the combination of these two sounds would be something like had you, or would you know, or could you tell me, or I need you to do something, I need you to. It's similar to this, but not exactly this one, because this is voiceless, nothing happens, nothing vibrates in your throat, and this is voiced. As I say, this is what you get in English when you say, for example, tin, or when you say in English, when you say John or George or bridge. And of course, some examples for you to actually hear this. In Dua Lipa's song Physical, you can hear it very clearly. She says, don't you agree, four times. You can listen to the song here. In Luis Capaldi's Before You Go, he says, he sings, I hate you, I hate you, I hate you, with this sound, the ch sound. I hate you, I hate you, I hate you. A very catchy song, a 90s song, but very catchy, I have to tell you. if you listen to it without the lyrics, it might be a bit tricky for you to know that they're actually saying, want you back for good, want you. Because this is what they're saying, want you back, want you back. This is, by the way, Robbie Williams, before he became a solo artist in his former group called Take That. So I hope I've convinced you that you can actually find lots of interesting information about how to pronounce English properly if you listen carefully to songs. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to give you some ideas of possible resources, possible apps that you can use to pay close attention to a song lyrics, to learn from it, to learn vocabulary, and also pronunciation. Whenever you think about pronunciation, if you want to know how to actually pronounce a word, please go to the Cambridge Dictionary. This is excellent, and this is what's going to tell you, and you'll be able to listen to it, how you have to pronounce a word in British English and in American English as well. However, sometimes there are some words which do not appear in a dictionary. Typically, place names, people's names, brand names. So for all of these things, you can go to any of these websites. What you can find in Forvo is actual people, real native speakers of English, pronouncing those words for you. And if you go to Youglish, you have to type in the search box, you type the word you want to hear, and it will take you to YouTube videos and exactly at the same point in the video where people pronounce this word for you. So all these three are excellent resources for you to know how to pronounce words or names properly. If you want to keep using songs, there are two apps that I really like. The first one's called Musixmatch. It's a database of song lyrics. You can go to the website here. It works both on Android and Apple devices. However, it has different functionalities. For Android devices, for example, and this is what you can see on the screen now, it has the option of going to YouTube, and then Musixmatch, if it is activated, recognizes the song, most of the time, 90% of the times anyway, and it will, if you activate the option floating lyrics, you'll be able to see the lyrics at the same time as it is playing in the song, as if it was a karaoke show. Something similar happens with Apple devices, but you need to either have the song on your device already, or you need to connect it if you are a user of Spotify or Apple Music. But again, what you could do, you would start playing the song and you will have the lyrics, you can read the lyrics and you can sing along to it if you want to. Finally, the second app I wanted to recommend is called SoundHound. You probably know about Shazam. This is an app which recognizes a song playing in the background. So SoundHound does that as well. If you listen to a song on television, for example, and you want to know what song it is, you can just start playing the SoundHound logo. And it will recognize what song it is. It will tell you what artist is performing it. It will also give you the lyrics, as you can see on the screen. And it will play at the same time as the song. So it is very good. But it has another functionality that Shazam doesn't have. And it is that you can sing along. You can hum to SoundHound. Imagine you have a song on your head, you don't remember the lyrics, so you don't know what it says actually. So you can sing to SoundHound, and if your singing is more or less accurate, or you know part of the lyrics and your pronunciation is more or less accurate, SoundHound will recognize the song you're singing, and it will tell you the name, the artist, and it will provide you with the full lyrics. So this is why I love SoundHound. So this is a summary of the four features of pronunciation, the four characteristics we've been discussing in this video. Aspiration, weak forms, initial S, and this so-called coalescence, when you say want you or good you. If you want to make sure that you can recognize them and then apply or use those characteristics, I'm suggesting this exercise here based on Coldplay's song The Scientist. You can go to the link I mentioned in the beginning, or you can scan the QR code here. You have an exercise, you have the lyrics to the song, and then I have pointed out some contexts where you might find one of these four features, aspiration, weak forms, initial S, or coalescence. So try and guess what or which of these four features is present, and then listen to the song, watch the video, and try and see if you guessed correctly. And then, as I said, you can, for example, try and read the lyrics and try and pronounce them the same way as Chris Martin, the singer, is doing it. You can even try doing it on SoundHound. Try to sing along this particular song and try to see if SoundHound can recognize it. So I hope you found these tips useful. Please keep listening to songs in English, just for fun, but also try to practice some active listening and try to spot these features of pronunciation I've mentioned in songs. That way, it will be much easier for you to incorporate them into your own pronunciation. Bye!